So welcome back to you students. Today's class we are going to see the design for shear in a prestressed concrete member. So we can see the question. The support section of a prestressed concrete member is 120 mm wide and 270 mm deep, is required to support an ultimate shear force of 90 kN. So it is given, width of the section is 120 mm, total depth of the section is 270 mm. The ultimate shear force to be carried is 90 kN. The compressive pre-stress of the centroidal axis is 5 Newton per mm square. That is, this pre-stress acting at the centroidal axis is given as 5 Newton per mm square. That is, your FCP value is given as 5 Newton per mm square. The characteristic cube strength of the concrete, that is, your FCK, is given as 40 Newton per mm square. The cover to the tension reinforcement is 50 mm. If the characteristic tensile strength of the steel stirrups, that is used, is 250 Newton per mm square, that is, we are using the stirrups having characteristic strength 250 Newton per mm square, design suitable shear reinforcement at this section. So you are asked to design it for carrying a shear force of 90 kN. So the first step, it's similar to what we have done for your RCC. We need to calculate the stress, shear stress carried by the concrete and the reinforcement and the pre-stressing steel. So first you need to calculate that. That we have done in the previous classes, how to calculate the shear strength of the section. But here we will do an assumption that, we will do an assumption because the data is given are less, or based on your marking scheme you can do that. We will do an assumption that you are having a, suppose you are having a concrete beam like this. The shear force will be maximum at these supports. The shear force will be maximum at these supports like this. So we will assume that the web shear crack is the main design, as this is the flexural crack. The flexural crack occurs like this. We will assume that the web shear crack is the one which is maximum. The web shear crack, or as the data are insufficient, we'll go for web shear crack. Or if in the question it is directly given, the concrete has been cracked in flexure, then you need to go for finding the flexural shear crack alone. That is, you need to find the value for VCR, unless and until we need to find the value only for V0. Okay, that is your web shear crack. In normal design procedure, we will go for finding both, and out of that we will find the lesser one. As mentioned in the code, you can see here for design of shear reinforcement, the ultimate shear resistance of the section alone, VC, should be considered as the both conditions, uncracked and cracked in flexure, the lesser value taken. That is, in the real case, we will go for that. But in numericals, if we have the insufficient data and all, we need to see which data are given. Based on that, we will make the assumption whether it is uncracked or cracked section. If it is a uncracked section, you should find the web shear crack. If it is given the cracked section, it is given directly as the cracked section, you can go for finding VCR. We are now clear with how to find the value for VCR and VC0. Okay, so now we will do the calculation. That is, first we need to find the value for tau V. Tau V is nothing but the maximum shear stress that to be carried by the section. That is 90 into 10 raised to 3 divided by BD, 120 into D. That is, here the total depth of the beam is given as 270, and here it is given the effective cover to the reinforcement is given as 50. We will consider this as effective cover, so it is 220. You will get this value as 3.4 Newton per mm square. So this is the maximum stress that will be taken by the section. You need to design it for this. Now the width of the section is 120, so based on depth of the section is 270, the shear force to be carried 90, and FCP value is 5 Newton per mm square. We have from your IS 1343, you have this value for your VC0, that is 0.67 BD root FT square plus 0.8 FCP into FT. That is, FT is 0.24 root FCK, and FCP is the compressive stress at the centroidal axis. It is given as 5 Newton per mm square. B is the width of the section, that is width of the rib, that is given as 120, and D is the overall depth of the member. So substituting that, I'll get the value for VC naught as 0.67 BW into D root of FT square plus 0.8 FCP into FT. So substituting this, I'll get this as 120, this as 270, FT as 0.24 root FCK, FCP as 5 Newton per mm square. We'll get the value for this VC0 as 62.8 kilonewton, which means this VC0 represents the shear taken by your concrete, your main reinforcement and your pre-stressing steel. Now actually this much amount of shear has to be taken, so the remaining shear to be taken by the shear reinforcement, and you are going to provide that. So this is L called as VUS, which is equal to VU minus VC0. So before that, you need to find this maximum shear carrying capacity. That is, you need to find the value for tau C, that is VC0 divided by BD. You will get this value as 62.8 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 120 into 220. You will get that value as 2.37. This is tau C. You will get this value as 2.37 Newton per mm square. You need to check the value for tau C max allowed for a section. You have the maximum tau C value as, the maximum tau C is for M40 concrete is 4, which means this is less than tau C max, so it can be carried out. Otherwise we need to go for redesigning the section by increasing the depth of the section. Tau C max is 4 Newton per mm square for M40 concrete, so this is okay. This case is done. So we can go for finding VUS. VUS is equal to 90 minus 62.8. You'll get this value as 27.2 kilonewton. So we need to provide the reinforcement for this much, or shear reinforcement for this much amount of steel. So we will assume 8 mm. Assume 8 mm bars for stirrups. So you have here in page number, close number 23.4.3, shear reinforcement. When V, the shear force due to the ultimate loads, is less than VC, the shear force which can be carried by the concrete, minimum shear reinforcement is given by this equation. But when it is greater than, when V exceeds VC, that is our case, the shear shall be provided such that ASB by SV is equal to V minus VC divided by 0.87 FY DT. In rectangular beams and both corners in tensile zone, a stirrup should pass around a longitudinal bar, a tendon and a group of tendons having a diameter not less than the diameter of the stirrup. The depth DT is then taken as the depth from the extreme compression fiber either to the longitudinal bar or to the centroid of the tendon, whichever is greater. So definitely we are having here the section like this. The longitudinal bars are placed like this, and the tendons are somewhere here. So DT means what? It is the up to the centroid of this section. So DT is always greater in this section, so we will consider DT as the effective depth itself. And V minus VC is your VUC. So from here you will get the spacing required. So I can write my spacing, that is SV is equal to ASV into 0.87 FYD divided by VUS. I'll assume 2 legged 8 mm bars, that is 2 into pi by 4 into 8 square into 0.87 into, that is 250 into 220 divided by, the whole divided by VS is 27.2 into 10 raised to 3. Solving this, you will get the value for SV as 176.85 mm. You will get the value for SV as 176.85 mm. But you can see here, The spacing of the stirrups along a member should not exceed 0.75 dt. Here dt is same as that of your effective depth, nor 4 times the width thickness for flange members. When V exceeds 1.8 Vc, that is your, this Vus exceeds 1.8 times Vc, that is 1.8 times 62.8, but in our case that is not exceeding, so we don't need to go there. If it is exceeding, then you should only go up to 0.5 dt. The lateral spacing of the individual legs of the stirrups provided the cross section should not exceed, at any case it should not exceed 0.75 dt. So the maximum spacing allowed for this section where V is less than 1.8 Vc, I can write maximum spacing is 0.75 dt. Here dt is equal to d, because that is the maximum distance from the extreme compression fiber to the centroid, either centroid of the longitudinal bars or centroid of the tendons, whichever is greater. So here we have d itself, so 0.75 times d, I'll get it is maximum spacing is 0.75 times 220, I'll get this as 165 mm. So we cannot provide the design spacing of 176, so we'll provide 8 mm two leg stirrup at 160 mm. We'll just round it up to the nearest 10, 160 mm center to center as the shear reinforcement. So this is the case for a design of shear reinforcement when the section is to be designed for web shear. Now we'll see one another question. You can see here the same question what you had done last time, but here it is asked a pre-stressed concrete beam 500 mm by 800 mm cross section M40 grade. At a particular section, the beam is subjected to an ultimate moment of 200 kN meter and shear force of 250 kN. Design the shear reinforcement for the zone near the section with Fe415. So here it is asked to design the shear. Given the section is cracked in flexure, you can see here the section is cracked in flexure. So you need to consider, when the section is cracked in flexure, the shear carrying capacity of the section is determined by VCR, which we had discussed in the last class. So, and the other data to calculate the VCR is given. So here the only change that is going to happen is, here instead of VC0, you need to substitute VCR, and the remaining things are similar to what you have done. In real case, what we do is, we will find out this VC0, then we will find out the VCR. From there, we will find the lesser of VC0 and VCR is your shear carrying capacity of the section, the shear carrying capacity of the concrete, main reinforcement and tendons. After that, we will find the VC, and the remaining things are similar to your RC design, because here the shear we are giving provided by the RC section. Only the change happening here is for the shear carried by the concrete, main reinforcement and tendons, and not You may see here the shear capacity of the concrete is very much high, as we are using high strength reinforcement. So I hope you are clear with this. We will see in the next class how to deal when there is a twisting moment coming on the section. That's all for today. Thank you.